Margot Francis Almonor rushed to Haiti the moment he'd heard from his sister. She spent 2 days trapped underneath the debris. And after arriving this week, he and his family are now more troubled by the lack of medical assistance.
A radio station blares loudly.
We've been listening to Radio Soleil. It's a radio station in New York that you could hear your family members from Haiti.
Eileen Almonor keeps her telephone close as she waits on word from her husband, Francis.
He's in Dominican Republic. His sister was transported from Haiti after the earthquake when her school building collapsed on her.
Her sister-in-law stayed trapped beneath debris for 2 days.
She called us on her cell phone while she was under the building and told us where she was.
She was finally removed from the rubble, and she's finally getting some medical attention.
At least that's what the family thought, but when he arrived, he found the opposite.
She is currently laying down in the hallway in the hospital. It is impossible to even see her when my husband tried to go there to even, you know, talk to her. Before she was able to talk, now she cannot talk at all. She is paralyzed from the waist down.
So the family decided the best thing they could do is to get her to the United States where she could get proper medical attention. And that's proving to be even harder.
The embassy council asked for him to provide med flight to the United States or $50,000 for them to issue the visa.
Because of her injury, she can't hop on the plane. She, like so many others, requires special transportation from a med flight, and that's a huge hurdle.
I've called nearly all flights that you could possibly imagine, and I do have Hendrix Mortar, Dave Dudley, who is currently, as we speak right now, is trying to help me to find a flight for her to get here.
As for now, their loved ones remains without care.
That's crazy. Especially with a crisis, you know, like this, it's a catastrophe in Haiti.
And that's a difficult part for the family. You know, they say they have plenty of family members here in the United States, North Carolina, Boston, and also New York. But they say coming up with $50,000 just to get a flight to the U.S. is virtually impossible. So they're just really hoping that the United States and the World Relief thinks about that in the days to come. Reporting live tonight, Margot, back to you.